Om Shanti, happy Friday everyone, TGIF. So guess what? We have another yoga pose and we're gonna try. And just remember everyone, these poses should be tried every day. You should just try to do one a day or try all of them. It doesn't take long. TGIF, I was thinking what would be a good pose for Friday, Friyay, would be Mala Asana. Mala is dirt and it's called the garden pose. This is great for men, especially for your pelvis area. For women, if you have any issues in that, what we call the first and second chakra, your survival skills, as well as your creative energy. So all you have to do in Mala is just sit here, watch TV, and open up your hips. You can roll your ankles in and out. I would just say this is the easy way, right? Now, you might want to go a little bit further. Who can take their elbows into the inner thigh area? Hands can go to prayer or not, or maybe you can keep your hands to the floor. Try to stay here for about 5 or 6 breaths. You know I'm going to give you the hard one. Now, this is the hard one. If you have any knee injuries or knee surgery, you might not want to do this one. Mala Asana, you want to connect yourself to the ground. You want to make sure you're feeling the earth, and that's the security that we're looking for. So this is the Mala Asana that I'm looking for. Now, you're like, wait, I can't do that. Hey, maybe you can find a little small stool, and you can sit on the stool, and you can try that as well. And sit up nice and tall, and this is just going to open up that first and second chakra. It's going to bring some blood flow in that lower area of your body. Another way of doing Mala Asana garden pose is that if you have a block, same thing, sit on the block. Try that. If you don't have a yoga block, hey, use the chair. Now, some of you might say, well, I can't get it down because I've had knee surgery on both of my knees. We suggest you take a chair or at your couch while you're watching TV, open your legs out, grab onto the top of the chair, and practice getting your ego on for Friday, squatting down. These are just deep squats here. You gotta be very careful that your knees are not going over your toes. Also, you can hold on to the bottom of the chair and go right into your Mala Asana. That might give you a little bit more support. I want you to open up that first chakra, that survival. Second chakra is your creative energy. So you want to open that area up. It's very important in your practice. All right, so we already did it. Mala Asana is your goal for this Friday. Now, everyone, remember, we discuss each yoga pose each day. Monday, for example, we did that little side angle stretch, a little triangle stretch, or just a simple side angle to work your latissa area. Tuesday, we did 2 poses. So I don't know if you remember, but we did a forward bending, meaning that we went down and tried to touch our toes. Notice I'm bending my knees, keeping it simple. And then we stood up and we did a couple of what we call balance poses, one leg up, proprioception. And then Wednesday, remember we did the down dog, we used the chair, and all I needed you to do was just lift your butt up and then roll back. And that was Wednesday hump day, we did the down dog, okay? And then TBT, we did a little bit of what we call tabletop, where we walked our feet out, we brought our hips up, and we dropped our head back. Good, I gave you all of the modifications, and today is Mala Asana garden pose, getting into the dirt, everyone. So I want to thank you so much for joining me. And like I said before, this is a gift that I'm giving to everyone. It's free. Yoga is free. It's your own body weight that you're dealing with. There's no weights here. There's no fitness equipment. It's just you, your mind, your body, and your soul. So get down on Friday and enjoy your Mala Asana. Dig into the earth. Thank you so much. Namaste. Have a great weekend. I'll see you on Saturday, everybody. And Sunday will be our last day. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm so grateful. Peace. Namaste.